火车窗后的人。以下这支影片来自于 TikTok 视频主 Fernando Victor Olive， 他是一名铁路行业的工作者。在一个夜晚的凌晨三点钟，视频主例行日常检查的工作，不过他没有想到的是，自己竟然在偶然之间记录下来了一幅毛骨悚然的画面。你注意到了吗？当视频主经过一旁的火车时，一扇车窗后面正有一个人注视着他。事情发生于凌晨三点钟，火车中不可能有乘客逗留，所以那一张诡异的面庞会属于谁呢？灵异酒店。
Okay, making a video. I'm here at the Providence Biltmore Hotel. I'm in room 1102. I'm making this video because it's like 2 in the morning right now. I've just been sitting here watching TV. And the door to my bathroom in this room has slammed2 or 3 times in the last half an hour. So I don't know why it's doing that, but no one's going to believe me if I don't get it on video. So I'm going to go over there. I'm going to try to catch this happening on video. The last time it happened was like about 6 or 7 minutes ago, and it's happening every 6 or 7 minutes. So I'm hoping to catch it again right now. Okay, let's check it out.
YouTube 频道主 Jack Stephens 入住了当地著名的闹鬼酒店。当夜，他便在房间中体验了一些怪异的经历。为了证实这些经历的可靠性，频道主将尝试用手机拍摄下来有可能会发生的诡异景象。
It just did it again. I cannot believe I got that on video. I cannot believe I got that. There is nobody in this room except for me.That is the freakiest thing ever. There's nobody back here.
In 影片的画面中，能够看到浴室的门果真猛然的关闭了。当频道主走进浴室后，同样可以看到里面空无一人。在这支影片的评论区中，一位名为 Leslie Barnett 的网友留下了一条评论，他声称自己在1996年入住了这座酒店，那个夜晚房间衣柜的门自己打开了。或许这真的是一座名副其实的闹鬼酒店。楼上的怪声。 YouTube 频道主 Hado 的家中又一次出现了诡异的声响，这次他手拿一个骷髅头法器，准备前往楼上一探究竟。 当频道主将房门打开后，诡异的声音也随之戛然而止了。随即他将骷髅头放在了地面上，然而只是一个转身的功夫，骷髅头便没有理由地倒了下去。究竟是谁做的这一切呢？附着于身，大部分灵异影片爱好者都会有一个疑问，常年亲身出入灵异地点的探险者们究竟会不会受到负面能量的影响呢？以下这支影片或许能够解开大家的疑问。 YouTube 灵异探险频道 Paranormies 近日上传了新的影片，本支影片与以往的内容有些许不同。这一次频道主 Jordan 讲述了自己的亲身经历。
I want to start off by saying that I'm sorry. We're sorry that we've been gone for so long. It's something that we never intended on doing, but something has happened that neither of us anticipated. A lot of you guys have asked since we started the channel if anything has been following us home or anything like that, and we've always denied it. But the truth is something very dark and something malevolent has been following me for a very long time.Honestly, I think it's been with me for most of my life, but it's only been physically manifesting itself in the last few months after exposing myself to other dark entities through the investigations on this channel.
频道主 Jordan 长时间有一种身体沉重的感觉，这样的身体情况在他开始进行灵异调查活动后变得更加糟糕了。频道主为了查明消极的能量是否仅仅依附在自己的身上，他决定远离众人，在家人的旅居车中度过几个夜晚。
You're hearing the sound all night. It's long.
频道主一整晚都可以听到类似于静电之类的声音，于是他拿起摄像机起身寻找声音的来源，但是听起来那个离奇的声音似乎无处不在。住在旅居车中的最后一晚，频道主经历了更加诡异的事情。
Who is that? Hello? Who are you? Why are you following me? Who are you? Anybody in there?
显然，频道主正在经历一些匪夷所思的事情。他认为自己真的被一些不干净的东西附着上了，无论他去到哪里都会被跟随着。频道主患有严重的睡眠瘫痪症，他声称自己在以往的睡眠瘫痪经历中看到过一个女人，而这一次，这个女人似乎更加真实地出现在了他的家中。
What is this? What's wrong? Something there? Is this what's going on?
一个夜晚，频道主在家中听到了一些奇怪的响声，同时家中的小狗也盯着一个方向，并表现出了紧张焦躁的样子。
Oh, I think I heard it. Yeah. That was really clear. Hello? So sick of this shit. what to do anymore. Hello? Fuck, what the fuck? Why are you following me? Who are you? Who are you? Fuck this. Fuck this shit. I'm so fucking done with this.
古怪的噪音，无人按响的门铃声，掉落在地面上的物品，以及玻璃窗倒映出的身影，过多无法被解释的诡异事件已经让频道主的精神接近崩溃。在影片的最后，频道主 Jordan 向精神治疗师寻求了帮助。不知道在这段经历过后，频道主是否仍然会坚持灵异调查相关的活动呢？但无论怎样，无数个像他一样的频道主，他们在面对未知世界时的胆识都足以让人感到佩服。